On the previous page, we looked at the overall anatomy of muscles, skeletal muscles. But now we need to look more closely at a muscle cell so that we can understand the subcellular components that allow muscle cells to contract. Now remember, muscles are organized into fascicles, which are organized into muscle cells, and something even smaller that's also cylindrical shaped is present inside of a muscle cell, and that's called a myofibril. Inside of every muscle cell are myofibrils aligned along the cell like long straws. In fact, about 80% of a muscle cell is filled with tightly packed myofibrils. Now, it's the myofibril that we're going to look more closely at to understand muscle contraction. But let's quickly look at another important component to muscle cells, and that is the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Now, that term may ring a bell. In cells, now this would be something you might recall from a general biology class, there are organelles within a cell, and there's an organelle called the endoplasmic reticulum. Well, in muscle cells, we call the endoplasmic reticulum more specifically the sarcoplasmic reticulum. The sarcoplasmic reticulum in muscle cells is a very unique organelle that wraps intimately around each of those myofibrils. And within the space inside of the sarcoplasmic reticulum, an important ion is stored. And that ion is called calcium. So the sarcoplasmic reticulum's job is to store calcium ion. So when the cell is at rest, when it's not being excited by the nervous system and it is not contracting, calcium is stored inside of the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Now, this will be important in our step-by-step process that leads to muscle contraction once this cell is excited. So let's look more closely at a myofibril. Now, each myofibril is surrounded intimately by that sarcoplasmic reticulum. And when we look at the myofibril itself without that sarcoplasmic reticulum, if we pull one of those myofibrils out and then we look at it, we can see that it's made up of what appears to be a repeating unit. We see a thick red line down the middle, and on either side, we see a blue zigzag to the right and the left. And then there seems to be some thick red fibers and some thinner blue fibers that overlap. And in fact, it's this unit called a sarcomere that is responsible for muscle contraction. And remember how muscle tissue and remember how skeletal muscle tissue is characterized by a striated appearance? Well, it's because of this overlapping of the thick red fibers and the blue thin fibers that gives muscle tissue its striated or striped appearance.